talk about MNsure, and we've asked Dan McLaughlin, the director of the Center for Health and Medical Affairs at the University of St. Thomas, to join us. Thanks so much for coming in. Now, there have been a few glitches this morning. It has been pushed back just a little bit, and the president said that we should expect that. We should expect some glitches. Do you think that will deter people from going online and trying to shop for insurance?
Well, I think the first few days will always be a bit of a challenge in any large system implementation like this, but we have to remember that people have 6 months, really, to take a look at health insurance options and find something that really suits them. And so if it's not working quite perfectly today, then I'd say come back in a couple days, and I'm sure it'll be working fine. If you sign up for health insurance in this first three-month period from now to the end of the year, your health insurance will start on January 1st.
What are some of the misconceptions right now out there about MNsure?
Well, I think one of the things that people still don't really understand is that it's only for a small set of people, actually. People work for small employers, or people, individuals and family that are uninsured today. People who are on Medicare, people who are on Medicaid, people who have employer-sponsored insurance won't have anything to do with MNsure, frankly.
Now, as far as the success rate, is there any way to gauge how successful this is, short-term goals, I guess?
Well, I think people have a pretty good understanding of the number of people in the state of Minnesota that are eligible to be in MNsure, and so I'm sure that the MNsure folks will be looking very carefully about how many people actually enroll. The other big policy challenge is to get younger folks to enroll into the exchanges, because we know that they tend to be healthier, and the money they bring into the exchanges helps subsidize people who are older and sicker. And so the real challenge is, how do we encourage those folks to sign up?
Now, we've learned that Minnesota has some of the lowest rates of people signing up for health insurance or health insurance coverage. Mm-hmm. Why is that?
First of all, isn't that great?
Yeah.
Isn't it great that we have such a great healthcare system in Minnesota? We also have some of the highest quality rankings. But I think the reasons people look at the low rates right now are probably two. One is because we've had a really good safety net in this state, which is community clinics and public hospitals and all the wonderful things we do for folks. The people who are uninsured today aren't that sick. So the insurance companies are looking at them and say, maybe we don't have to charge them. Second thing is, we've been way ahead of the curve on cost management over the rest of the country. Mm-hmm. And people that, we teach a lot of doctors at St. Thomas, and those physicians are in leadership positions. I know the projects they're doing, and they have been slowly pulling the waste out of the system. And so we're starting to see some of the impact of that. And that really makes me very optimistic about the future of costs in the state.
Okay. Dan, thank you so much for coming in, for your insight today. And we want to mention that we posted the MNsure Fact Checker on our website. Just head to our homepage, click on the MNsure Frequently Asked Questions tab, and that is at the top of our homepage. Eric.